You can sit down before we play this other prayer. Sit down. Just for me. I need to tell you of the testimony. And it's a real life testimony. It's not a story of the doctors and the emperor. No, sir. It's a real life story. May the help over your life be totally open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The last time we want to pray is to pray that the Holy Spirit of God will empower us. We'll take over our hearts and our life. Our Lord, and our Jesus. When the Holy Spirit goes before you, he do anything that you are doing. Whether business wise or whatever, I'm telling you, your life is subject. Your life is subject. Praise the name of the Lord. There was no rich man who discovered, who just saw this man and discovered that this man is suffering too much. He saw another person suffering. The man asked him, alright, call the man that suffered, that man suffered. He said, come, I want to help you. That was the time when the movement was people having to travel from their country to developed countries, either to Europe, to America, to London. That was when it was really, really moving. So the man said, alright, let me help you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So the man took money. Gave money clearly, which he was going to use for flight and everything, but the normal thing is that first of all have his visa. Without visa, he cannot travel to any of these places. So the man said, I will help you. And the man knows some people in the embassy. He said, alright. He saw those people at the embassy. Say, I am sending somebody. This is the fellow, this is his name, and so on and so forth. Say, as soon as you see him, just give him his visa. Every other thing concerning him is ready. I have the money for his life, I have everything. Look at me. That first day, when the man was traveling to the embassy to obtain visa, it would have been an easy walk over for him. All he needs to do is just to get to the embassy. But the help over his life was good. And that is not any man can do with the door. So while he was going on the way, armed robbers across their way. That was how he delayed it. He could not get to the embassy. So the message came to the man who has already arranged for him at the embassy that way. Will you see your man? What was that about? See me, see you. This is exactly what happened. He not went back to the man who was trying to help. He went back to him. He said, all right, okay. He arranged with it. So someday, you will go back to your passport. Take your passport and so forth like that. They will give you your visa. Lo and behold, while he was good, say the first day it was accident. Oh, it was abnormal. The second time he was going, it was accident on the road. He spent more hard work accident. That was the second attempt. Because the heaven over his life was what? Was totally short. It was a heaven of grass upon his life. And it was somebody who asked the heaven of grass, so I said, let anybody who meditate to want to help such a person do not fall. Like I said, the final prayer I want you to pray is to call upon God. Lord, baptize me with your Holy Spirit. Let the heaven over my life be totally open. Let it be totally open. Praise the name of the Lord. And that's the third attempt for that man. Another third attempt. The man who was trying to help him said, well, I will make sure I satisfy God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The man that changed it, he said, alright, maybe there is a demon on the way from your town to Lagos, where you have to obtain the visa. Let me now send you to Abuja, the capital of the city. The capital of that nation. The man will not get to the embassy on time. That third attempt. Suppose you are going to be the president to help him. What will you do? Somebody there, give me an answer. What will you do? In most cases, any natural person wants to give us. I think there will be something in that this person. I say, this person cannot be here. Let me go and help somebody else who can be here. Praise the Lord. Rise on your feet, brethren, and call upon the Lord as you know. Father, fill my life with your Spirit. Speak of the living God. Come and flesh of you. Fill my life with God. So that the heaven of my life will not be short. In the mighty name of Jesus. So that the heaven of my life will be total.
Brethren, shall we open our mouths and begin to pray? Let's pray for our pastor. Let's pray that the heaven over his life and ministry will be open in the name of Jesus. Shall we open our mouths and pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your Son, Lord, that you are used to deliver the word of life, even unto us today. Lord, I pray that the heaven over his life and ministry and family will be open in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray, God Almighty, Lord, that the splendor of your glory, your power, you are wanting to come upon you in the name of Jesus. Lord, Lord, I pray, as we have had your word today, regarding open heaven, I pray, oh God, as we have decreed that it is so, that our heaven will permanently open in the name of Jesus, that we will enjoy, oh God Almighty, your presence all the days of our lives, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank and we bless you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Amen.
Let's appreciate God for
the pastor and his family, the workers and all the members of this church, for how the Lord has been keeping them. Let's give him praise and return the glory to him. Father, we worship. We bless you. Oh Lord, our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We give you praise, oh God. The Bible says, ever before the mountains were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your presence in this place. Thank you, Lord, for your grace upon this assembly. We give you praise for provision, open doors. Thank you for the heavens that you have opened upon this house. Lord, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the children. Thank you, Lord, for those who came into this place and you have blessed their lives. Thank you for transformation. Thank you for people that you brought out of the darkness, even into your kingdom, the kingdom of light. We give you praise, Father. Please accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying with us.
Amen.
Now we're going to ask the Lord. This is the fifth year. And of course, we all know that the number five is the number of grace. Apostle Paul said, I am what I am only by the grace of God. When he petitioned heaven about the weakness, the thorn in his flesh, Jesus replied him and he said to him, my grace is sufficient for you. In this fifth year of the existence and establishment of this parish, we want to trust God for the release of grace as they have never experienced before. Please, would you like to open your mouth and ask the Lord, please release upon this house abundant grace, exceeding grace. He said, I never more than all the other apostles, but yet no power, but the grace of God. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask for God that in this fifth year, grace will release in a dimension they've never experienced before. In the name of Jesus, grace that makes good. Grace of God, Lord, release upon this house. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise and we give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Lastly, I want us to pray. And in addition to what I'm raising, the prayer point I'm going to raise, you can also add anything that you feel that you want to just ask the Lord to release upon this house. But the last prayer point is that we're going to ask God to release upon the segment fresh portion from above. And that God will build into the people that God has given to him. And that by God's special grace, from this point, everyone is arising to build in the name of Jesus Christ. So let's pray for fresh unction, fresh anointing from above in the name of Jesus. Lord, let it be fresh each day in the name of Jesus Christ. The freshness that comes from the presence of God, release upon this place, upon your servant, in the name of Jesus Christ. Prosper the work, O God, that you have committed into his hand. Lord, raise up the people to be in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise and we give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying with thanksgiving. Gracious Father, we rejoice greatly this evening. We rejoice because of your faithfulness to your people. We thank you, Lord, for the last 4 years of your faithfulness to them. Thank you for all the things that you have done. Thank you for what you are doing.
Thank you, Lord.
And thank you for what you are going to do
Lord, we give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Please accept our thanks in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, the Bible says concerning the Nehemiah, when he shared the body that was placed upon his heart with the people, after he had received favor from the king, and now he had taken his journey to Jerusalem, shared the body with them, and the Bible says, and the people arose to be because they had mind to work. Lord, we ask that that kind of grace settle upon this house in the name of Jesus. The name of this church is True Vine Parish, and your word says, as we plant our root downward, we shall bear fruit upward. Let it be the portion of this church in the name of Jesus. Whatever you decree in this place, heaven will stamp it in the name of Jesus. Whatever you ask to come, we come for you in the name of Jesus. Whatever you command to go, we go in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare according to the word of the Lord and by the Spirit of the living God, no weapon formed against this parish shall prosper in the name of Jesus. All that you need to build according to divine pattern, may God release to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Resources you will receive in the name of Jesus. Provision receive in the name of Jesus. Grace for the work, receive it in the name of Jesus. All the children in this church, they are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. They will grow up to become mighty upon the earth in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. And because of this church, Bognor Regis shall be saved.
Amen.
This land shall be saved.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you,
we give you the praise.
Hallelujah.
And we give you the glory.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Praise the Lord.
Shake it together, running over, If that is what you are trusting God for as well, it's an opportunity for you to sow something and see whether God is not going to return it back to you in multiple fold. I trust the Lord that He will do so. He will return it back to you in multiple fold in Jesus' name. Amen. So, as I said, it's time for us to give our Thanksgiving offering. And if you are writing a check, please do write it in the name of the Redeemed Church of God. I'm just shutting RCCG through my parish. If you are, if you're writing that check, make sure you date it and you sign it as well. Amen. And make it an offering that is befitting unto the Lord. The other thing is, if you are a taxpayer and maybe you're a member of this church already, you're a taxpayer, you have a gifting number, make sure you put that on. If you're not a member of this church, but you want a gift to be, you want the church to claim gift aid over your giving, please do fill the necessary part of the form on that envelope that you have given. Praise the Lord. So shall we have a little choir who's going to lead us, even as we joyfully, give our offering today. Amen. Amen. Are we ready? Amen. As I said, more than the gift that you are giving, it is the joy, it is the dance, it is the appreciation to God from the bottom of your heart, the dancing, the singing, the expression of the gratitude to God that is most important. So shall we be on our feet?
Yes. Jesus.